Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. In this video, I will discuss about Down syndrome. Down syndrome was first described by John Langdon Down, an English physician, in 1862. He defined a distinct pattern of physical and intellectual characteristics in a group of individuals and published his findings in 1867. However, it was not until later that the chromosomal nature of the condition was understood. In 1959, Jérôme Lejeune, a French geneticist, discovered that Down syndrome is caused by an extra copy of chromosome 21, a condition known as trisomy 21. This breakthrough established the genetic cause of the condition. Down syndrome, also known as trisomy 21, is a genetic condition caused by the presence of an extra copy of chromosome 21. Normally, people have 46 chromosomes arranged in 23 pairs. However, individuals with Down syndrome have an extra chromosome 21, making a total of 47 chromosomes. This extra genetic material affects the development of the body and brain, leading to the characteristic features of Down syndrome. Global prevalence of Down syndrome is approximately 1 in 700 to 1,000 live births. Symptoms include flattened face, almond-shaped eyes that slant upwards, short stature, short neck, hypotonia, small ears and mouth, simian crease in palm, intellectual disability, delayed development, etc. There are three main types of chromosomal abnormalities reported that can lead to Down syndrome. First one is trisomy. 95% of cases of Down syndrome have trisomy 21. Second one is mosaic Down syndrome. 1 to 2% of cases are of mosaic. And third one is translocation Down syndrome. Remaining cases are due to the translocation. The primary risk factor for Down syndrome is maternal age, but several other factors may also influence the likelihood of having a child with the condition. As a woman gets older, the likelihood of having a baby with Down syndrome increases. This is due to changes in the act of over time that affect chromosome division during pregnancy. While maternal age is the primary risk factor, older paternal age may also play a role. Some studies suggest that men over 40 may have a slightly increased risk of fathering a child with Down syndrome, though the effect is less pronounced than for women. Non-distinction of chromosomes is an error that occurs during cell division, either during meiosis or mitosis, when chromosomes fail to separate properly. Non-distinction is the main cause of syndromes such as Down syndrome, Edwards syndrome, Patau syndrome, Turner and Klinefelter syndrome. Down syndrome can be diagnosed before birth, that is prenatal, or after birth, that is postnatal. Prenatal tests like amniocentesis or chorionic villus sampling can confirm the diagnosis. After birth, the characteristic physical features often led to a clinical diagnosis, and genetic testing such as karyotyping can confirm the extra chromosome presence. while there is no cure for Down syndrome, early intervention through therapies like speech, physical, and occupational therapy can help individuals with Down syndrome develop their skills and reach their full potential. With support, many people with Down syndrome lead fulfilling lives, attending school, holding jobs, and being part of their community. Advances in healthcare and education have significantly improved life expectancy and quality of life for individuals with Down syndrome, with many living into their 60s or beyond. This is all about Down syndrome. Thanks for watching this video. So today we learned about Down syndrome, its causes, symptoms, and how it affects the body. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with friends or family to spread awareness. If you have any questions or personal experiences or stories with this disease, drop a comment. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of yourself. Thank you. Thank you very much.